Hello everyone, welcome back to Elden Ring. I got a new headset, and it's got pretty colors that change every so often, so you might be seeing that here and there if you're watching, you know, the side of my face, which I might consider moving my webcam over. Also, I forgot to read a lot of lore to a lot of things I collected, but that's just, I felt like I didn't have the time to do it, and I just was more focused on doing the game, playing the game, same thing. There was actually a secret area to Stormveil that I almost forgot about, because I'm like, I feel like I'm missing something, and then it hit me, I'm like, there's a secret area to Stormveil, but I'm like, I found it by accident on my first playthrough, so I need to figure out how to get through it. So, as far as using the guide goes from here on out, I'm going to avoid using it because I understand that it's more fun. Like, even though I've beaten this game before, I've got the receipts on my PlayStation 4. I mean, wait, why am I... I've beaten this game before, so that's why I'm not kind of going into this blind, because I've played it before, I've gotten used to it, and the reason why I didn't, you know, go into it blind initially is because A, I wanted to play it, and B, I'm like, I knew everybody and their mother was going to be uploading content on it, they were going to be streaming it and all that other stuff, and plus, I got to watch other people be miserable with me on some of these bosses, and, you know, it was fun watching, like, Bricky, Zeusier's Toast, V-Sweat, Skillakilla, which is, one I actually got into because of Elden Ring, so I kind of found him through the other ones I just mentioned, and there's a couple others I, started following on Twitch. I almost said Twitter, I'm like, well, I mean, I would also follow them on Twitter, but mostly on Twitch. Yeah, Jesus here still, at least as of the recording of this video on May 9th, he's been absentee. I don't know what's going on with him. I hope he's well, but, yeah, his chat, and I'm partially to blame because I did accidentally give a little bit of a spoiler about a certain boss in this game. But I kind of think he already knew it, but it was also one of those bait questions where he anticipated people would answer it, and then anybody that did answer it, he put on like a 10-minute timer or whatever. But then there was this one douchebag that I just, out of the fucking blue, when Zeus had reached the final boss, actually just spoiled the whole fucking thing at the end, and he got pissed off to the point where he like straight up walked off cam. I believe his mod Mitch, which shout out to Mitch, you know, salute my guy, because you're the only mod on there as far as I know, and jeez, I'm sure that shit can get annoying too, dealing with all those fuckers. Man, I myself and there were like two others that did the same thing that I did. We felt genuinely bad for, you know, giving that spoiler, but it wasn't a major spoiler, so at the end of the day, it wasn't that big of a deal. It's just, you broke the rule, you get punished, punishment was served, there you go. Also, and this is totally 110% an excuse, I was drunk as shit and not paying attention at the time, so that's why I said what I said, but yeah, anyways, back to the story. So he gets spoiled on the, like, the ending, and he... Zeus just does not want any kind of spoilers, none whatsoever, unless he explicitly, and he makes it clear when he's genuinely asking for, like, hey, how do I do this, how do I do that, otherwise he does those bait and switch questions, which, fair enough, you know, he's trying to see who's gonna fall for it, and then, you know, he does what he does, but the dude walked off camera for, I want to say, like, a good 2, maybe 3 minutes, and I was pissed for him, because I'm like, even I, in my drunken, not paying attention state, would never have said what was said about the final boss. Like, I was pissed off for him. And I'm like, yeah, get this fucker out of here. And I believe he was, like, permabanned. Granted, you know, once, with you know, time heals wounds and all that shit. So I guess if they decide to come back, then I think Zeus would, you know, lift the ban. But still, I can't blame the guy for being that pissed off, especially with how much he was enjoying the game, he was loving it, he didn't want any spoilers, and my god, the backseating was actually getting to me, because, like, when I was streaming on Twitch, I didn't really deal with much backseating, but I honestly would not have minded it, because I probably 9 out of 10 times would have ignored it, or otherwise used it, but not, you know, given them the audible cue that I was listening to what they were saying. But I understand why some streamers get sick of that shit, because it's very insulting to them. It's rude. It's like you're acting like you're better than them, and then they straight up say, like, no backseating, so don't tell them how to play the game unless they explicitly ask you. But when it comes to spoilers, I'm a very strange creature when it comes to spoilers. 90% of the time, I don't give a shit. If you spoil something for me, I'll be like, okay, well, whatever. I probably looked it up anyway, so, you know, you're wasting your time trying to spoil me. That's also another reason why I just jumped straight into Elden Ring, because I'm like, I'm going to get spoiled. Listen, I watched up to 800 and, like, one of the late 800 episodes of One Piece. And yes, I watched all 800 plus of them up to that point. I somehow managed to avoid every spoiler in One Piece up to that point. I somehow avoided spoilers for all those years. The only thing I knew about One Piece is that it was about this guy named Luffy. He has rubber band powers, and he wants to be King of the Pirates. And I know that there's, like, you know, characters like Nami, Zoro, Crocodile. I knew about them, but I didn't know where they fit into the story, when they showed up, what they did, if they were alive or dead or anything like that. So I somehow managed to avoid spoilers. And I'm like, I wasn't even trying to avoid spoilers. I just happened to avoid them. And, like, these people were asking, like, how the fuck did you avoid spoilers all those years? I'm like, I don't fucking know. I just didn't really pay attention to it. And then until, you know, I got a Funimation subscription, I just started watching it. And I'm like, yeah, fuck it. I'll watch One Piece because I keep hearing about it. So why not? So yeah, I got to watch One Piece blind, and I got to binge it for 800 plus episodes. And thankfully, there's not that much filler, so it's like, you know, for Naruto fans, I feel yeah, the filler. God damn. There was so much filler to Naruto. Like, I think that one's the king of filler right now. Anyways, I've been rambling for almost 10 minutes. Hell, I'm not even tapped in back into the game yet. That would have been so fucking funny if the lift wasn't there and I just, like, slashed and then rolled off. Alright, so I believe I go up here, and I forgot to adjust my fucking brightness settings, but okay, I guess it doesn't matter here. Frame rate's a little better, I think. It's looking like it's about the same on OBS. Yeah, it's about the same on OBS, but for my in-game, it's actually looking pretty good. Alright, so we hop up here. Oh, by the way, if you're trying to figure out where this fucking thing is, I mean, there's... You know what? Screw explaining what I'm about to do. I'm just going to leave a link to the video that I found, because it's like 2 minutes 38 seconds. You just got to go into the description, look at it, watch it, and you're good to go. I'm going to do that. That would save both you and me a lot of time. More importantly, it would save you guys and gals a lot of time. I was going to say, isn't there a... There's a bird and a dog. Or no, is there two birds? I can't tell what the hell those things are. Like, what up here? Oh, yeah, I go through here. Right, okay. I don't have to fuck with them. Good. I hate birds in this game. I hate birds in general, aside from, you know, a select few species. Let's see. I should be able to hop over there and grab that. Smithing stone two. Oh, three of them. Nice. Nothing over there. Okay. Now I'm gonna try to figure. Is that a fucking? Is that a grace? Smithing stone. Somebody's attacking something. Oh, it might be the jar guy. Okay, it's probably the jar guys below me. Let me also get that on. Which, I have noticed that the, there's a guy up here. I have noticed that the lantern works better than this thing, but this thing's more convenient. Oh, right. That reminds me. Now that I've noticed I don't have it out. So, okay, here come these schnuckle bags. Okay, I might need to lower the game volume. Oh, hello. I might need to lower the game volume a little bit. Well, maybe not. No, I need to lower it a tiny bit. Oh, fuck, hi. Holy shit, how many of you jokers are there? Quite a few of you little shits, huh? Oh. Commoner's headband, okay. Oh, is there another one of you up here? Yep, there is. Time to die, douchebag. Actually, the volume on my end's fine. It's on OBS, so I'm kind of worried about. So let me adjust it a smidge. Okay. Hopefully that's not. No, that might be too quiet. That should be fine. Alright, so I think I'll go through here. Oh, sweet, I needed those. Let's turn that off. Do I hop down here? Do I hop down there? Is that a cave? There's our doorway that I'm missing. Let me do this number. No, not that. What? Oh, okay. No, get that out of here. There we go. Do I hop down here? I'm not sure. I mean, it's not a big deal if I don't. I just have to, you know. Actually, I won't even kill these guys a second time. I'll just kind of run through them. Yeah, I think I just go down here. Well, okay, let's explore the Curious Mind. See what the Jesus, I almost fell off to my death. Okay, yeah, I think this is where I go. Oh yeah, you gotta hop up here. I don't know why it makes you hop up there, but, you know. I think you should be able to just pick it up by standing near it. Ramble stone, okay, cool. Wait, hold on, what? That just took me back to... I mean, great, we unlocked that door, but... That didn't take me to the underground array, so I think I fucked up. No, actually, it took me... I did a complete fucking circle. That's... Wow. Well, that's how you unlock that door, so I got that out of the way. So, yeah, we'll be in Stormvale for a little bit. Alright, I might need to play the video a little bit more. I would set it up to where you could watch along with me, but let me just skip ahead. If you're in the back, well, I mean, if you're in the back, that's not a big deal. No, so, okay, so he hops on. Wait, no, he hops on there. Okay. Yeah, he went exactly where I went. Okay. Oh, okay, I think I see where I fucked up. Yeah, I think I see where I fucked up. Okay, cool. Yeah, fuck that switch in particular. Yeah, let me just repeat it. And I'll just run past all those, Chinooks that I fought earlier. Oh, wait, no, that's not the right way. I'm supposed to be above the jar doohickey dudes. Wait, what the hell? Did Kakarot screw this up? Oh, wait, no, I didn't screw it up. Okay. I was getting confused because I thought the jar guys are, like, at the ground level, not, God, it's the ninth time. This shit's gonna suck. Okay, I was like, I'm not gonna make that jump, but thankfully I made it. Yeet! Okay, let me run over here. Let me go up here. Doorway where all the dudes are hanging out, chillaxing, smoking the good shit. I just broke their box, but I'm sure they'll get over it. So yeah, I hop down here. Supposed to be something that I jump onto, though, around here. Oh, right. Okay, it's over. Yeah, it's right here. Is that a sludge thing? Oh, no, it's a bat creature. There's another one. Down you go. I don't know how that second hit got you and the first one didn't, but alright, well, whatever. As long as you got hit and you died, that's the important part. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, shit. No, come up here. Come on, you can fly. Get up here. Stop flying around. Gotcha, bitch. And I got those boxes, because fuck those boxes in particular. Shit. Okay. Before I go down there, let me see if there's anything to snag over here. Doesn't look like that there is. Alright, so let's go get that item then. Yoink! Smithing stone plus two. Not sure if there's a shortcut to this area or not. So I don't have to do all the hippity hoppiting and whatnot. But I don't think there is. That's a rat. Oh, hello, big ratty. Down you go. Should just probably get that back out. What the fuck is that noise? Oh, it's one of you! Rancor call. Oh, okay. That's an Ash of War. Yeah, I don't use that. Okay, down there, there's a mini-boss. I remember him. And it's one of my least favorite enemies in the game. We've already met one of them before. The, what are they called? Ulcerated Tree Spirit. I'm sure I didn't use, like, hardly any healing items, so it should be alright. At least I don't know how to get down here. I mean, granted, if I die, it's gonna be a fucking chore to get back down here. Damn it. Oh, how did that hit me? Bullshit. Oh, he's gonna explode, fuck! Oh, sweet. Fuck. Damn it, I can't see shit! And I missed out on that critical. And he's gonna blow up again! God damn it. Jesus. Got him, though. That's what I mean, though, is say, like, you get, like, clocked in, you know, I'm rolling with it, clocked in a corner with these clowns, and you can't see shit. Storm Sword Key, that was definitely worth it. Let's get that thing out. Alright, let's see what dirty little secrets Godric's been keeping under here. Well, Godric and Marge. Which, you're gonna love the thumbnail for when I upload that video. Prince's Death Postal. Prince of Death's Postal. Isn't that tied to Fia's quest? I'm gonna actually have a chat with Fia. Oh, hey, yeah. Meet Godwin. So, in the beginning of the game, they actually mentioned that a demigod died. And, well, here's what's left of him. Or his physical body, at least. But there's also another part of him that's elsewhere, but we'll worry about that later. That won't be until... Actually, yeah, that won't be until a little bit later. Probably like 5 or 6 videos from now, if that. Like, at the earliest. Yeah, that's the... Actually, let me... Hold on, I know I gotta go back up this ladder, but let me double check because, what the hell? Oh, I thought there was like an added area to this. I was like, oh, hey, I didn't see that before. Yeah, I think that was everything because there was other items that I could have grabbed. See, like, now, this arena size for the Ulcerated Tree Spirit... Actually, hold on, looking at it, it's about the same size as that other boss arena that I fought him in. No, actually, no, this one's slightly bigger. I think this one works better-ish, maybe. I mean, it's an obvious boss arena, don't get me wrong, but... I don't know, with the Ultimate Tree Spirits, I just don't like how they move around, hog up the camera, and if you get, like, stuck under them, and it's like, I can't see what the fuck's going on, so I'm just gonna keep hitting the attack button until hopefully the thing dies. So, yeah. I might need to lower my microphone volume a little bit. Is that 2 decibels? Well, I mean, it's not, it's in the red, like, it's crossing in the red here and there, but it's not like, you know, like, yo, shit, you're fucking loud as hell. Actually, you know what, let me be on the safe, well, let me climb this ladder first. Holy shit, this ladder is fucking long. And I cannot see shit. I hear a rat. Or is that a mouse? Oh, hey. Ooh, a somber smelling stone. Rank 2. Not a bad find at all. Oh, shit, it's him! And he saw me because I heard the music go bump. Iron Wet Blade. Hawkcrest Shield. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce what the hell that. Oh, hi! Oh, yeah, then, yeah. Then you can fall down to death. Never mind, do I have a ranged weapon yet? I do, but I can't use it because I lack the dexterity to do so. Oh, does shitbag see me? Yeah, B sees me. Where you at? Might just use OBS for this. Come here. Come here, douchebag. Come on. Come at me, bruh. Come here. That was stupid of me. Oh, come on. Okay. Yeah. I was gonna say he got me. I was trying to be a cheeky dick waffle with him, but obviously that didn't work. So the ash award that I was referring to earlier, where I don't have to take out my shield, is called like No Ash or something like that. Alright, let's go to the Rampart Tower. Looks like it's the closest one. I actually find them like mano y mano, or try to at least. Alright, whoops. Nope. Let me get my shield back out. Actually, I'm curious, do all these shields have parry? Oh, wait, that one has no skill. Sweet, okay. Because I know that leads outside, doesn't it? Where the birds and shit are? Yeah, it does. That fucking knight down there. I think he walks outside. Hopefully I can get behind him. Haha! Surprise, motherfucker! And if I die on my way to this, Scion dude or whatever, then, you know, it's whatever. Oh, fuck. Hi! No, eyeball gouging for you. I think I teleported to the wrong spot. Did I teleport to the wrong spot? I think I might have teleported to the wrong spot. Because, yeah, this is the opening area. Oh, wait, no, hold on. If I... If I drop down? No, because now I'm facing away from him. Well, let me think here for a second. So when I went to the lift side chamber, how did I get there? That's right, I exited out of the secret area, and I'm definitely not... I almost hit the wrong goddamn button. Hold on, actually, maybe if I drop down here, and then down here... I don't think, actually, this is where I want to go. I think I'm going back in a circle again. Yeah, I definitely just... Yeah, it was a complete waste of time. Somebody's pissed. They don't notice me, though. Interesting enough. Sorry, I'm processing, like, how the fuck? Well, because isn't that the door that's locked? That's right, you unlock the door, you climb the ladder, you come up here. You come up here. You do this thing. You fight douchebag McWhirlwind up here. I still can't activate. And Jesus, holy hell, what the hell was that lag? There's that. And I can't activate that. Nor can I jump down, because I would fucking die. Oh, wait, do I... Fuck, I gotta run past these stupid-ass birds, don't I? Well, this is gonna suck ass, but let's go. I hate these fucking birds so goddamn much. Oh shit, did I go the wrong way? I might have gone the wrong way. Fuck! Haha, can't get me in here, can you, Birdman? Oh, hello.
Ah, nice to meet you.
Random.
The pleasure's mine. Roger is the name. A sorcerer, as you might have guessed. I'm looking for a little something here in the castle when I'm not hot for
one of them died.
But enough about me. What are you doing here in Stormvale Castle? This place is bristling with tarnished hunters, you know. They sacrifice our kind for grafting.
I noticed.
Not exactly a place I'd stroll into without a purpose in mind.
I can't tell you. It's top secret information.
I see. Here to challenge Godric and lay your hands upon a great rune, are you?
Maybe.
You can see it then, I take it. The guidance of grace. Well, enjoy it while you can. I'm tarnished, like you. But unlike you, I've seen neither hide nor hair of this guidance for the longest time. Still, I won't forget how it felt when I first came here, to the lands between. I'm privy to a few magical battle arts. Would you care to learn one?
Maybe.
As a fellow tarnished, once guided by grace, I'd love to help you out, if it please.
Yeah, sure, what do you, nothing I can fucking use or let alone afford, because all my runes are currently, over there.
Oh, keen.
Nope. Alright, well, there's, Roger. Just randomly found him. That's where that one dude is. There's those two chuckleweeds. Oh shit, I gotta run past these two fucks. I mean, the knight's not a problem. Or the, excuse me, the dude with the torch isn't a problem. But this dude, on the other hand.
Thank you.
Okay, never mind. That wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad at all. What shield am I using again? The Mar de Leather Shield. Okay, I think this is the right area. Yeah, I just heard him smash into something. Yep. Okay, cool. Alright, now I just gotta get down there and get my runes and figure out where to. Oh my god. How do I just. Do I just wanna hop down? Do I just wanna hop down there? I'm just gonna hop down there. Fuck it. Dude. Booyah. Okay. Hey, douchebag. Come here. Oh, he can attack the walls, but I can't. I see how it is, game. Well, whatever. Took care of you. Not the fairest way to take him out, but this game doesn't play fair, so why the fuck should I? Alright, so that said. Yeah, so that's the secret area done. Shit, I got some real done in a video and a half. All I gotta do is beat Godric and we're done. Woohoo! How many Rooney thingy mabobs do I got? Oh, wow, I got quite a few. I was trying to see if I'm banking on me being able to get a level out of all this. Oh, yeah, for sure. I should definitely be able to. So I need how much? I need basically 9,000. Okay. We'll use half of these. Perfect. That is exactly the amount I needed. And we'll teleport right here, and then we'll just march off to fight Godric. Hey, that all worked out fucking perfectly. Thank you, Stormveil. Alright. What do we want to increase? Strength? Not really. Endurance is a definite maybe. Actually, I need to increase my dexterity so I can use that bow. So we'll put it into dexterity. Switch back to that shield. Yeah, so that no skill thing that it has, I need an Uber shield that has it. And I want to say the fucking the bronze shield has that. What the fuck? Oh, it was the torch. There's somebody behind me with a club. Oh, that's for Lady Lou. I want to summon her for Godric. She is storyline. This is storyline driven more so than what Rogier was with Margit. Actually, more than anything, I want to get a golden shield or a bronze shield. That reminds me, didn't I get Yeah, I got some Exile Gauntlets, but they're inferior to my Godric Knight ones. I was going to say, I'm assuming this is the best armor I've got right now, unless I want to worry about how much fire damage gets bombasted on me. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I would wear those, but it's just the feet look so damn stupid. I got the exile hood. I don't like it though. I like my it just looks so much cooler. Don't want to have at least one go at those knights and see if I can get a damn shield from them, a bronze shield. I kind of do, but at the same time, if I just get parry, then it's like, well, what's the point? Oh, well. You know what? Let's see. Let me get my shit sorted out. Do I have any more of those raw meat things? I do not. I have blood grease, though. Fuck it. Well, yeah, I could use that. That would help me get, or that would increase my chances of getting it. I don't want to do that off screen. No, fuck it. I'll give it one round. Cause I want to use that that foot or whatever. So we'll spawn right there. I want to say that's where I get that shield from, and you know, it's kind of a testament to me saying I'm not using guys anymore. You know, I'm just gonna kind of go at it as blind as I can. Yeah, cause I want to say that that bronze shield's going to. Let me use the silver foot, because the silver shield that I'm wearing right now and the other one are basically one and the same. That's why I'm thinking that I'm not gonna get it. Lord Sworn's Bolt. Make sure work I am. Jesus! Okay, I still have that effect going. Cool. Let me go rest at the thing of grace up here before that wears off. Where's the other one with the shield? Blah, blah, blah. Oh, there he is. Nope, never mind. That's the spirit guy. Oh, nice. Oh, he's over there. No, not him. Him. I don't want bolts. You son of a bitch. I want your goddamn shield. I got smelling stone out of him, that's nice. Where the fuck's the other one at, though? Like, that dude's kinda just hit. Okay, my thing wore off. Oh, there he is! Alright, one more try without the Silverfoot thingy. So no, they're both basically like over here. Yeah, here's one. No, he didn't drop it. Ow. Stop giving me crossbow bolts, you fucker. Alright, well, screw it. I'll just have to auto-change between keys, or shield, or whatever, with the fucking blood attack. But then again, I might not need, because I don't think I needed it for... No, I know, I did use it on what's-his-face. But, oh well. Okay, yeah, I was going to say, this is the right summon area, right? Yeah, okay. What up, Godric?
Mighty dragon. Thou'rt a true born heir. Lend me thy strength, O kindred. Deliver me unto greater heights. Well.
Actually, kind of reminds me of Arthas. At least with the long hair and whatnot.
Lonely tarnished.
Handy!
Playing as a lord. I command thee, Needle. I am the lord of all that is golden.
And handsy. And he's a roly-poly! Oh, shit. Jesus. Oh, damn it. I thought I was far enough away. Damn elevation. Oh, I rolled right into that like an idiot. Oh, whoa, shit. Fair enough. Okay, that obviously that bleed wasn't doing shit for me. Because I noticed it wore off. I'll give it. Yeah, we got four. I'll give it another shot. Oh, I forgot to fucking use the damn thing. Hold on. Give me a second, sir! God damn it. Yeah, I got stuck. Ah, you dick! Oh, that reach, you bitch. Aye. Damn it. I keep trying to get like a quick in and then block, and clearly that's not working in my favor. My god, man, the amount of stamina this dude sucks off. Oh shit, we hit the halfway point. Oh, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Why did I do that? Granted, he's not as fast with his second form. He just Abraham Isaacs himself.
Truest of dragons.
I didn't do very well in his first form. I'm kind of disappointed myself because I used like half my healing up and that last one that I used. Grr, rawr. I'll give Godric points. He looks pretty damn cool with that dragon head. Shit. I also gotta remember, he's got that grab of shit. Fuck. Oh, yeah. Okay, I survived. Fuck. What the hell did that miss? Oh, you broke my guard, you bitch. No, you're not grabbing me and I'm out of fucking healing. You fucking fucker! Oh, you bitch! I got so fucking cocky. I got so cocky. I'm so mad at myself right now. God damn it. Yeah, that blood shit's clearly not doing a fucking thing for me, so let's try something else. I don't think he's weak to lightning. Definitely don't think he's weak to fire. Oh man, I got like a little adrenaline rush going. That was a good fight. Like, I'm not even mad that I lost that one. That was just good. Shit. Damn it. I really wish, can I craft those things? Oh, I can, but I need... Basically, I need to go butcher a shitload of animals. And I can only make three anyways, because I would need to kill a bunch of... I would need some lump of fleshes. I'll give it one more go, and then I'll go hunt some beasts. Why did I roll when I rolled? Oh, fuck. God damn, man. That combo he does is ridiculous. Yeah, that one. That combo. I hate that combo. Whoa! Would you stop missing? Dick!
Thou art unfit even to craft! The power of the dark side owes her lips.
I was doing so well, too. But he kept using that stupid combo. If I can. My thing is, if I can get him into a second phase, he's much more manageable. Like, his attacks hit harder when he's in his second form, but they're less quick. You know what, screw it. Let's bring in our, let's do a tag in. Because I feel like I'll save more time if I just summon her than go and hunt down those fucking animals and shit. Whoa! What the fuck? I was about to say, I wonder how many hit frames that damn... Fuck. Oh, that fucking combo. Oh, nice, nice, nice. No, you idiot. Oh, smack the shit out of him. Oh, that actually can hit. Oh, that's... I actually like that. That can hit you. That's... I rolled into it. I'm getting greedy. Okay, he's on me now. Get shrecked, bitch! Oh, that didn't do a damn thing! Ha-ha! We gotcha! Good job, Nelfi, or Nefli, or whatever the hell your name is. Damn, she took a hell of a beating. I feel like I carried that at least 50%. You guys could give me 50%, right? Oh wow, he actually gave me a good chunk of thingamabobs too. Yeah, I'll put one into strength. Could probably upgrade my weapon at this point. Oh hey, it's you.
Craven to the bone. Pushing me about like that. And after all that grafting, where did that get you? Look down on me, would ya?
Oh! I didn't mean to do that. Hold on. Cut! Retake! I didn't mean to attack the guy. Okay, good. He's back to his thing.
What a pathetic excuse for a lord you were. Craven to the bone. Pushing me about like that. And after all that grafting, where did that get you? Look down on me, would ya? Godric, you filthy slug. Feel it. Feel it. Feel my bloody wrath.
Are you all right there, buddy? I just don't know. I mean, you just took one hell of a hit. I cracked your head so hard, it popped right out of your body. And it is funny as shit. Anyways. All right, Lucille, back to your corner where you belong.
Oh. Hello there.
After I bonked him.
This weasel was Godric. Was always looking down on me. He got what he bloody deserved thanks to you. I tell you though, what goes around comes around. He had an ugly heart, an uglier countenance, and met the ugliest of ends, eh?
Jesus Christ, man. Maybe lay off the... Oh, are you gonna buy shit off of you? Huh. Ooh, a buckler. Bandit guard. Yeah, I don't care for that. Feathers I might care about, though. And the great arrows. Cassis, that's a weapon that I don't care for. Oh, that reminds me. We're going to do a lot of reading here in a bit. Because there's a lot of lore that I'm going to cover. Mostly for myself. Because there's a lot of shit about the story I don't know. I think I might have mentioned that in an earlier video. But, yeah, there's a lot of, like, lore and shit that I don't know. Yeah, there's really nothing I want to buy off this. Well, I guess I could take those off his hands. Actually, fuck it, I'll take these as well. I'm not doing any PvP. He can keep his rune fragments. Ooh, yeah. I need to bear in mind that he's got those.
Now, I suppose I'm free. I can do whatever takes my fancy. Can I, mate?
Now, that does make him sound very sinister, but he's legit. He just straight up hated Godric here. I mean, as you can tell, he's fucking stomping on him. Yeah. Take it, Godric. Feel his wrath. He's facing defeat. Shout out to Epic Rap Battles of History, which, by the way, guys, the fuck you at? What are you guys up to? I mean, I know COVID's still afoot, so I guess recording can be difficult at times. Ah, oh, me throne! Keeping it nice and warm for me, eh? Hold on, do I have the pose? Switch. Yeah, I got a pose. You see this, Godric? This is my house now. You fucking cunt. This is my house now. Actually, I'm not gonna lie. My character looks kind of cool looking like that. Okay, but enough of that. Remove. Not in thought. Remove. I want to keep the finger. The finger? Finger. Snap. Alright, I just get my shield back out. Wait, did I have my shield away? What the hell did I have my shield away for? What the fuck? What is wrong with me? I don't think there's any hidden room. Are there? I don't know. Let's see. Why can't... Wait. I can't attack. I can't attack in here. WTF. Huh. All right. I know why. It's related to a quest later on. So I'm going to head down here. I'm going to talk to an NPC. Then we're going to head back to the round table and tell everybody the good news that we killed well, he wasn't really a demigod. It's more like he's a descendant of a... Excuse me. Descendant of a demigod. God damn it. Might need to get some water. A Shabiri... Actually, since I said we're going to do a lot of lore reading anyway... Oh, is that a key item? Yeah, it is. Okay. A yellowing, oozing eyeball of the infirm. God, it looks like one of Birkin's eyes from Resident Evil 2 Remake. The surface is shriveled and the inside is squishy, not unlike a large, overly ripe grape. Give to the blind maiden to guide her to the distant light. So yeah, that's part of a storyline that actually can affect the ending of the game. Bunch of dots. Maiden, dear maiden, where are you? Please check me grapes. So, you know, Mappo, as of my recording of this video, he's on episode 36 as of this morning on May the 9th. He actually does interact with the paintings that you collect. Now that I'm thinking about it, because one of the paintings involves one of the little ghost guys you encounter. I'm probably not going to bother with the paintings. I don't have a reason to. If you want me to, I will take requests, but only requests that are like, hey, do this painting... And da da da, and you just gotta name it. I'll do all the research and everything, like how to get to it, what it leads to, and all that other stuff. But yeah, you just gotta name it. You just gotta tell me the painting that you want me to do, and then I'll do it. But by and large, the paintings I'm pretty much gonna ignore because I've ignored them on all 1, 2, 4 of my playthroughs. So yeah, we're now outside of Stormvale. Now, do we run into what's his ass, or do we run into? No, that looks like the girl.
Hello?
Yeah, it's the girl. Okay.
Is someone there?
Hi.
My name is Hayata, and I'm journeying in search of the distant light. If I might be so bold as to ask, would you donate any Shabiri grapes in your possession to me? My eyesight has been weak since birth, you see. I can't tell which way I'm supposed to go next.
That's why you eat carrots.
When I eat one of those grapes, I can feel a distant light in the back of my eyes. It will lead me to my true duty as a finger maiden.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, many thanks to you. Now I can feel the distant light once more. You are most kind indeed. May the blessing of the fingers be upon you.
I'd like to bless you with my fingers, but Oh, that's God, that sounded better in my head than it did, you know, coming out. As you ish. Oh, does that auto-equip? Okay, it doesn't. Cool.
You are most kind indeed. May the blessing of the fingers be upon you.
Is that it? Okay, yeah, that's it from her. Alright, let me roll over the skull! Oh, never mind. It was one of the ones that has souls in it. Or runes or blood echoes or whatever the fuck. Holy shit, look at that sight. Let's take this sight in. Hold on. Get up there. Look at that sight. Goddamn, FromSoft. This place is magnificent. Sorry, I've been watching a lot of Walking Dead and just Negan quotes are coming into my head. So, over there we got a church, so we're probably going to find a whatchamacallit, a fucking thing that upgrades my flask of Crimson Tears there to rank 6. In the middle there, above my character's head, is the Academy of Liurnia. I think it's called, like, the... No, actually, I forget what the hell it's called. Over there, I think we have the... It's like a big mountainous area or something to that effect. Down there, we got basically Louisiana. And over here, we have the Divine Tower of Liurnia. Which also reminds me, I need to make a pit stop back to the Stormveil Castle. Because there is actually a Divine Tower I gotta get access to. So that I can get Godric's rune, if I can say the guy's name right. And, get that, because as you can see, there's like, you know, a little thing here, so and I think the best way to get there would be to unlock the gate, but I'm trying to remember how the fuck I do that. Oh wait, no, I might need to start from, no, not secluded, actually, yeah, it might be secluded, so I'm basically reverse rush through this area, which is going to be painful. We're gonna be on the warpath, we're gonna be fighting a lot of fucking dudes to get there. There is a lion you fight. I might completely skip over. Oh, no, I'll fight it. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But yeah, that is pretty much Limgrave done for the most part. I mean, I'm sure there's a couple of cases where I'm going to pop back here. I mean, hell, I still got to kill the one dude that's supposed to pop up. Yeah, right there where Bernal is. But yeah. You know, welcome to Liurnia, the second main area of the game. Even though we already visited Kylid, or whatever the hell you want to call it, for a bit. Actually, if I'm not mistaken, isn't there a church, like, not too far from here? So I might be able to get, a little upgrade early on. Yeah, okay. There's a church right here. Yep, Sacred Tear. That's what I meant to say. Oh, hello, you.
You're tarnished, aren't you?
Bitch, I might be.
Then perhaps you could spare some runes. Believe it or not, I studied glintstone sorceries at the Academy of Rhea Lucaria.
Lucaria, that's the name.
Small donation. I'd be happy to share my knowledge.
2 runes, yeah, sure, why not?
Bless you, bless you. You're a true saint.
Not really.
My name is Topes. Presuming you're interested, I can teach you sorceries, as promised. Only, none of them are particularly great.
What do you got for me, Chief? Nah, he's not wrong. These are kind of shitty ones, but... All the same, thanks for the offer, any hoot.
Apologies, friend. I'm afraid my meager sorceries are no match for your generosity. Oh, right. I can tell you what I know about this place. That should help a bit. You've seen that structure to the north, towering over the water. That's the Academy of Rhea Lucaria, where we study glintstone sorceries. Only its doors have been closed for quite some time now. After they declared they wouldn't interfere with the shattering, the Academy cast repelling seals on the east gate leading to the capital, and the south gate leading here. As you might have guessed, the seals are still active, making entry to the Academy impossible without a glintstone key. And so I'm stuck here. A fledgling sorcerer with little chance of acquiring a key. When they cast the seals, I'd just popped out. And now I'm uprooted from my place of learning. why not find yourself a glintstone key? Without one, you can't pass through the academy, and you'll never reach the Erdtree capital. And if you find an extra glintstone key, perhaps, once you've tied up all your loose ends, and I can be very patient, would you consider donating it to me?
Okay.
I'm a bluntstone. Nary a hint of talent for sorcery. But still, my place is at the academy.
There are, in fact, two glintstone keys you can find. I know where one is. The other one, memory escapes me. But okay, if I find that second one, I'll definitely come back and chat with this guy. And there's no time limit on this guy, so...
You've taken an apprenticeship with Selen.
Indeed.
Well, that is something. Selen was well known. The most promising sorceress in the history of the Academy. I followed her at school. But there may as well have been an ocean between us. But Selen was expelled from the Academy, accused of unthinkable treatment of certain sorcerers, under the name of the Graven Witch. I still don't believe the accusations. The illustrious Selen would never do such things.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, for those of you savvy to the lore of this game, isn't the Graven Witch the one the Godskins used to work for before, you-know-who came in and basically told them, no, I'm shutting your shit down, get out, bye. He's one of the latter bosses of the game. Actually, we technically met him already, but... It is the Graven Witch. I think it is the Graven Witch. Oh, I'm 100% convinced it's going to be a DLC boss for this game, because the Godskins are like their own. They're like the Enclave of this game. Not necessarily the Enclave. Like, let me give you context of what I mean. So in Fallout 3. The Enclave are the main antagonists of that game, technically. But what I mean by that is, they are a remnant of a greater, older power that was not particularly good. Because in the Fallout universe, the Chinese and American governments, they were both equally shitty. They were both equally terrible. We don't know what happened to the Chinese government or what even happened in China in Fallout, but we know what happened to America, and... America got split into various factions like the New California Republic, the Brotherhood of Steel, the Minutemen, and the Enclave. The Enclave is the remnants of the United States government. So the Godskins, I think, were supplanted by the people that worship the Erdtree. And what the Godskins are, the name kind of implies that they killed gods and donned their skin on them. They kind of wore them like war trophies or garments, even. Like, it's basically like, I killed this god, I'm going to wear this god on me, yeah, as a sign of my power and whatnot. Now, the Godskins are not nearly as powerful as they used to be because of a certain character that came in and basically fucked their whole shit up. And the dude's a badass. I can't wait to fight him. I'm probably going to get, massacred by him a good number of times, but he's one of the best bosses in the game. But yeah, that's what I meant when I compared the Enclaves to them, is that they're like an old world power. Like, they were here before the Erdtree was, and they were doing things before the Erdtree came and became the new powers that be. Oddly enough, though, they had nothing to do with the current events going on right now. Like, they had nothing to do with the Elden Ring getting shattered. They had nothing to do with the conflict between Radahn and Melania. They had nothing to do with any of that, because they were already, like, pretty much put into exile by the guy that kicked their ass. But yeah, okay, so we met that NPC. Well, hey, there's a couple of bunny raccoons, or whatever the fuck those things are that we can kill to get those bones on. And you know what? Fuck it. Let's do the thing. Hey, bunny raccoon, or kangaroo, bunnies, or whatever. Time to die. Okay, I didn't get shit out of you. What about your buddies? Come here, Thumper. Alright, well. I'll go for you then. Give me your bones, you bastards. Speaking of bones, yeah, we're not gonna wander there too quickly. Hey, you, come here. Give me a shit butter, or you're not even a shit bird, you're a raccoon. He didn't give me the bones that I needed, I don't think. Oh, did he? No, he didn't. I need to hunt particularly large beasts. Particularly large animals, not the little tiny buddies. Alright, so, yeah, let's head back to here. And this is where I'm going to do a lot of my lore reading, so if you're like, I don't give a shit about the lore, this would be the time to end the video. And skip over to the next one if you're still interested in watching my playthrough of Elden Ring. I don't have any dialogue with you.
Ah, you appear to be doing well. Very good. Well then, would you like to learn an incantation?
I already got everything I wanted out of you.
The golden order shines through you.
Yeah, sure, whatever. Anyways.
Hello. You've been busy weeding Deathroot, I take it.
Indeed.
I thank you, as your brother in arms. So what can I do for you?
What incantations do you gotta keep? Okay, yeah, stuff I can't afford.
Be sure to tell me if you choose a servant.
Okay, yeah. Goddamn, dude, we get it. Oh, there's Raj here. Okay, now he's here.
We meet again after all.
Indeed.
I apologize for any offense given by my bearing, but I'm quite unable to move, you see. So, what do you need?
Okay, so I just realized that he's got like a blanket over his his legs and whatnot. For some fucking reason, I thought he had just like a dress. Like I thought that was his dress, but it's not. Or not a dress, but a like part of his robe or something like that. And I always thought like, man, those colors do not mesh. Like, what the hell are you wearing? And hell, is his leg glitching through? His leg is glitching through the damn thing. Come on, FromSoft, seriously.
Ah, you defeated Godric and claimed yourself a great rune. Looks like we both got what we wanted out of Stormvale, didn't we?
Indeed.
Well done, friend. Something to mark the occasion. Go on, take it.
Is that +8 rapier? Yeah! I might be able to beat the Crucible Knight with that now.
As you might have guessed, I still can't move. My fighting days are behind me. No need to be polite. I've no use for it anymore.
I mean, I know he meant his sword that he just gave me, but I mean, you know, he's like, it's all right. I don't have any use for it anymore because I found the one that I'm going to be spending the rest of my life with, aka Fia. I think him and Fia got, you know, a little thing going on.
The misshapen corpse under Stormvale. That is a sacred relic of the Black Knives plot, as that famed night of assassination is known. It happened during the golden age of the Erd Tree, long before the shattering of the Elden Ring. Someone stole a fragment of the Rune of Death from Malaketh, the Black Blade, and on a bitter night, murdered Godwin the Golden. That was the first recorded death of a demigod in all history. And it became the catalyst. Soon, the Elden Ring was smashed, and thus sprang forth the war known as the Shattering. I once wished to become a scholar, you see. I've spent many an hour scouring the archives for knowledge of that fateful plot. The world has grown crooked, and if you intend to put it to rights, you'd better understand what happened to make it this way. And that thing is to blame for the shape I'm in now. I urge the utmost caution. Don't disturb the corpse more than necessary.
So what I just took from that is basically Godwin the Golden was killed, or assassinated rather, by the Black Knives, and we don't know who the Black Knives work for yet. But Godwin's assassination was the spark. He was the Franz Ferdinand, if you will, of the Shattering, which would, I guess, could be considered like the Great War, the war to end all wars, aka World War One. And, you know, that was fought mostly between Radahn and Melania, but also between the other children of Marika, Marika, whatever the fuck you want to call her, between, you know, her kids, and all of them fought to a complete stalemate, and now the world's pretty much fucked, because we don't have an Elden Lord, the Elden Ring's shattered, world's in chaos, and so the Tarnished are coming back to basically be the ones to fix it all. That's what the Fingers are trying to do, at least. And if I'm wrong in anything I just said, do let me know, so that way my audience knows that, like, no, this is actually what happened. But what he said is that the condition with his legs, where you can see, like, there's a couple of, like, little flies buzzing around them. He's actually got, like, some rot growing on his legs, so he can't actually walk anymore. And it's because he got close to that, the head of Godwin that we found down below. Obviously, we weren't affected by it for whatever reason, but it affected him, and that's why he's like, well, listen, the only reason I was trying to even get near that guy or that guy's corpse is to understand why the shattering happened in the first place. Like, who did it? Why did it happen? Da-da-da-da-da. And unfortunately, he paid the price, and now he's telling us, like, hey, listen, don't let what happened to me happen to you, because you go near that thing, bad stuff happens. So yeah, we're definitely learning a lot of lore here.
Ah, so you've met D.
The Will of D.
D is an old friend. We found ourselves journeying together for a time, bound by our exploration of death. But our paths have since diverged, never again to cross. Though that's hardly an uncommon fate for two friends.
What skills you got for me? Oh, you got Ashes of War. Spinning weapon. Huh. Okay, cool. That's all from him. Now, I think I can go get some more dialogue out of Fear, or maybe out of him?
Did you need something else?
About Rogier.
Are you acquainted with a man named Rogier?
Yes.
You know, the piteous fellow hiding away on the balcony. He was a formidable spellblade in times past. Don't let his easy air deceive you. He was wise beyond his years, stout of heart, and clear of mind. No more, though. You see him now, ravaged by thorns, muttering and rambling, like he's half dead already. I can't stomach to watch.
Yeah.
Take well the lesson, friend. That's how you end up when seduced by those who live in death.
Oh, wait.
The race is sullied. It rots people from the inside. Breaks them.
I wonder if because he got close to Fia, if Fia's the reason why his legs are, you know, basically rotting. Like, the dude's literally dying right now. He's decaying from the inside out, so he's essentially a brown recluse bit him, and now he's just, his body's turning into mush. And then Rajir over here is telling us, like, hey, be careful of those, you know, death maidens and shit, because you know, they may look attractive and pretty and everything, but the second you let them in, oh boy, they're gonna tear your world asunder. Oh, finally she's here. This is the girl that was like, take care of the things or whatever, and she gave us the octopus that, oh shit, I should've used the octopus against fucking Godric. Well, no, I feel better about using Nephili or whatever the hell her name is, because she wanted to take down Godric too, so I felt it was appropriate for me to use her in that fight. And, damn, I came so fucking close to killing him too. If I hadn't used that one healing item before he turned, I'm pretty sure I would have beaten him then and there. And I've beaten him solo before, so... Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, when I did my solo run where I'm like, I'm not using any summons, I actually had a lot easier time with Godric because I beat him on my... my second attempt. Marika, for some reason, took me like 12 or something like that. Like, Marika was just beating my ass. That's where I came up with that theory that I said that Marika gets less aggressive if you're less aggressive. Like, if you're calm and collected, then he's calm and collected. Like, he reacts more to you than how you react to him. But, I don't know if that's true now. But, yeah, with Godric, I mean, I still... The only attack of his that really, like, dealt me in was that fucking wombo combo he was doing. But everything else, I think I was getting the hang of for the most part. And that's another thing as well. And it's something I learned late into my Soulsborne experience is that dying to bosses isn't inherently a bad thing. It's learning the bosses what you need to take away from each defeat. Learning their patterns, their movements, everything like that. Because some of them have telegraphs, some of them, when they start an attack, there's a bunch of shit that follows, and you just gotta pay attention to how many times they hit the ground or swing or whatever. The only thing that kind of threw me off this current bout of rounds with Godric was the spin-a-rooney attack, because I didn't realize how many frames he hit you for, because I thought it was just one, two, and then the big slam attack. But no, he hit me like three times before he did the big slam, so that's why I kind of was confused at first. I'm like, hold on, why did he hit me three times when he should only hit me twice? But yeah, that's the big thing, though, is that my assumption and like how I wanted to present myself as a Soulsborne player is, if I beat the boss the first time, then look at me, I'm a badass. That's not necessarily true, because if you beat the boss the first time, it's like, okay, great, for your playthrough, you're good, you're fine. But when you come back to that boss, let's say you beat them offline, not on camera, or you just beat them in general, you come back to that boss, and they suddenly start kicking your ass, and you're just wondering, well, what the hell is going on here? It's because you don't know all their attacks, because they didn't get to use all of them because you beat them the first time. So losing isn't inherently a bad thing, because as long as you pay attention to their attacks and you learn their attacks, and even though I've given like the ulcerated tree spirit and the Darkrai bird shit, because I don't like them, I think they're terrible in design and all that stuff, if you still learn the patterns and everything like that, you will get better fighting them. You will eventually get better fighting them. Now, are there some attacks that are complete and utter bullshit on bosses that we've encountered and then that I haven't fought necessarily yet in this current playthrough? Abso-motherfucking-lutely. There are bosses that have attacks that are bullshit. There are even enemies that have attacks that are bullshit. There are even abilities that I have that are technically bullshit. But that's kind of how this game works, is you just gotta out-bullshit the bullshit. And that's not to say that it's like, well, you just win by, you know, using rigged things and hacks and blah, blah, blah. No, it's not that at all. It's you win the game by learning the enemies, learning the patterns, memorizing them. And eventually you'll get that shit down and you'll kick the crap out of everything that comes in your way. Now, will you do it easy peasy, lemon squeezy? Yeah, absolutely not. But you will eventually do it. And I'm sure you've noticed by this point with how I deal with bosses, in at least in this playthrough, if you've watched up to this point from start to finish, is that I am very, very aggressive to a fault with the bosses. I like to just wail in on them. I am very greedy. It is an inherent flaw that I have, and I think Bloodborne's to blame for that, because whenever you attack the boss in Bloodborne, you get some of your health back, and I'm still used to that. Like, in my deepest, darkest subconscious, I am still used to getting that health that health back, and all the health recovery stuff you get in here from attacking an enemy or with a combo or something like that, it's not worth it. Even the buff you get from Melania's Great Rune, it's not worth it, because actually with Melania's Great Rune, I think it's, if you get smacked a couple of times, there's a, like your health bar will dim for how much damage you took, and then if you hit the enemy a couple of times, you recover that health, but you have like a time limit on that and all this other shit. And anyway, Jesus Christ, I've been rambling for a hot minute. Holy hell, we've almost gone on for 2 hours.
Greetings, nice to see you again. My name is Roderica. I should have told you sooner. Isn't this place impressive, though?
Indeed.
The Round Table Hold, covert quarters of the Two Fingers, and gathering place of champions who vie to become Elden Lord. I never knew the guidance bestowed upon us Tarnished had such fantastic roots, although it's all a bit much for me, in truth. I'm still looking for my own purpose.
So, back to our regularly scheduled programming here. This chick is the one that gave us the squid summon. Or as Jesus here still affectionately called her, the gaming journalist. Which I don't know why I find that so funny, but I thought that was just such a great way to talk about her. But yeah, she's kind of a friendo from here on out. We're going to talk to that dude. But yeah, that other room should be open now. Yeah, there it is. Now look at that ugly ass thing. Two fingers. And then there's this old lady here. Which, she can kind of cash in your chips with bosses you've defeated.
Are you that new Tarnished?
Yes.
You've done well. I am Enya, the Finger Reader. I interpret the words of the Fingers, envoys to the Greater Will. Look there. The Fingers tremble. To welcome you, Shardbearer, let their wisdom wash over you.
Great Elden Ring, root of the Golden Order, anchor of all lands, giver of grace, wellspring of all joy. Until it was shattered, the tragic corruption of the Order has taken its toll. Across the realm, life lies in ruin, fallen to pieces. Foul curses and misery spread, unabating. But the Greater Will has not abandoned the realm, nor the life that inhabits it. So it is that the Tarnished are guided by grace, called to act. Brave Tarnished, your great rune is a handsome shard of the Elden Ring. Seek another of its kind to become Elden Lord and restore the Golden Order.
Let the words of the Fingers guide you.
So the way that she changed her voice, it made me think of how Ygritte from Game of Thrones would mock Jon Snow. Like, she would deepen her own voice and be, you know, just like, I don't know how to do this. Look at me, I'm Jon Snow, and I'm scared of naked girls. Oh, man. Ygritte and Jon's relationship was so great. Yeah, season 4 was literally the last great season of Game of Thrones. Like, season 5, okay, you know, it gets a pass here and there. Season 6... I will say that I don't think the writing was particularly good, but Battle of the Bastards, holy shit, that was a fantastic cinematography experience. Like, that was great. Top to bottom. Season 7 started off really good and then kind of devolved into kind of mediocre stuff. Season 8, you know how I feel about that one. And if you don't, clearly you're not watching enough of my videos. Watch more of my videos. Subscribe. There's my, eBegging. Well, I guess actually, yeah, it would be eBegging. But I'm not eBegging. But anyways, yeah.
Well, I see.
You don't have any eyes. How can you see shit?
Has found its way into your possession. Demigods and even the Creator of the Champions are hewn by the Erd Tree upon their end. Into remembrances. They are valuable indeed. These remembrances yet house the power of their former masters. And should you wish to wield that same power, well, I will lend you the strength of the Fingers. Do not recoil from my offer. The Fingers guide us all. And you, Tarnished, you are here to take, are you not?
The shocker. Listen, old lady, I want you to keep your oversized shocker away from me. Yeah, sure that. Oh, so Godric's thing. Yeah, I want to get the dragon mitten there, but I don't have two. Apparently, I don't have 2,000. Oh, I got 500 or 400 some odd short. Anyways.
Great runes are the.
Stop saying ah.
Gods, the children of the goddess Queen Marika, she who is vessel of the Elden Ring, tainted by the strength of their runes. Her children warred, but none could become Elden Lord. And so grace was extended to your kind. the tarnished. Listen. The fingers speak.
The greater will has long renounced the demigods. Tarnished show no mercy. Have their heads. Take all they have left.
Indeed. But remember one thing. The demigods are each and all the direct offspring of Queen Marika. Godric the Grafted was but a distant relation, the runt of the litter. His divine blood sorely diluted.
So he was kind of a demigod, but he wasn't, you know, comparable to, let's say, Radahn, Melania, or what's another demigod we know of in this game? I guess those are the only two we. Rickard, yeah, the great blasphemer. So yeah, was not comparable to any of them. But he's kind of like the, like think of the demigods as like the Lannisters. Like Marika is like Tywin Lannister. She's the head honcho of the bunch. Or I guess it'd be more fair to compare her to Olenna, but, you know, because Olenna was a badass in her own right. But think of Godric as like the Lance Lannister of the Lannisters or the demigods. Like, he's just, nobody gives a fuck about him.
Now go forth. Let the words of the fingers guide you.
Yes, I will let the words of your oversized shocker guide me. So, like I said, oh, hey, you there.
Oh, this is a rare occasion. I can't remember the last time a new tarnished made their way to the round table. Very well. As your senior, I bid you welcome.
Thank you, Witch King of Agmar.
It is safe here. You may let down your guard.
Okay.
Allow me a word of advice. As your senior, you are a mere visitor to the round table. Nothing more. A house guest. Yet to earn their keep. Remember your place, newcomer.
Remember your place, peasant.
There's nothing left to say. Be at your leisure.
Okay. Even better. Let's go talk to Hewig, and then we'll talk to Fia, and then...
Well, look at you.
Look at me.
Those eyes tell a story of a challenger who's felled her mark. Fine and well. Now lay out your arms.
Okay, arms are laid out. Do what you will. Oh, he meant my sword. Okay. I thought he meant literally, like, lay out your arms. I'm like, here you go. What are you gonna do? I'm down for a good time. Oh, you... Ah, seriously. Wait, what? Oh, three. Okay. Okay, that makes a lot more sense. Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm stuck with this heater shield, so fuck it, we'll upgrade it again. I didn't know I had the... Oh, I didn't know I had Reduvia over here. How you doing, my honey duck? The only reason I can't upgrade is because I'm too broke, and that I... Oh, shit, I do need to level up or I can't use it. Fuck. About Roderick... Roderica... God damn, can I not say her goddamn name? Roderica? Is that how you say it?
Look at you, boy.
Yeah, her.
She has a gift for spirit tuning. I saw another one like her long ago. Their eyes share the same hue.
Okay, so I can get out of him. Alright, let me go talk to her again. Oh, so let me get this shit back out now that the joke's kind of over. You there.
It's all a bit much for me, in truth. I'm still looking for my own purpose.
Tell her what the blacksmith said. Don't tell her.
You're telling me I possess.
Indeed.
I don't believe you. But if I do have this talent, and goodness knows it would be my first, I suppose I should try to hone it, shouldn't I? I'll ask Master Hugh to teach me. Certainly he does appear intimidating and holds no love for us tarnished. But I know he's trapped here at the Round Table Hold. So I can tell. He's a gentle soul underneath it all.
I mean, on the Bart, she's cute as hell, but I also gotta say, like, I mean, unless that clothing she's wearing is exaggerating, man, she got some fucking hips, which means she's got some thighs, which means, waifu.
If I do have a talent for spirit tuning, then goodness knows that would be a surprise. I suppose I should try to hone it, shouldn't I? I'll ask Master Hugh to teach me.
Oh, Hugh. It's just Hugh. I thought it was Hewig. Not Hugh. You know what, fuck it. We're gonna call him Hugo Weaving.
Back already? No matter. Lay out your arms.
Okay. Oh, wait, hold on. No, never mind.
The girl. What about her?
Alright, were you reaping the dialogue? Oh, yeah, would you watch over her?
Are you out of your mind?
A little bit.
You'd stay with an ugly brute who only knows how to smith. Absurd. Besides, she'd never agree to it.
I beg to differ.
I refuse to believe it. I don't doubt you, but I know when something's too good to be true.
Oh, he just wants a friend. Do I have to talk to her again? I'm sorry for this, like, back and forth, like, messengering that I'm doing. So, yeah, I tell him, and then he's like, okay, fine. And is kind of stoic. I'll do it, but I'm not going to say that I'm going to do it kind of way. All right. All right, Fia.
I am pleased to see you again.
Me too.
Would you like me to hold you once more?
Oh, please hold me. Hold me till the end of time.
Now, come closer.
Oh, she meant to her, not you guys. My bad. Sorry, social distancing. Sorry for the camera warning.
So very warm.
Yes, I get the debuff. Talking secret. There we go.
I was known as a deathbed companion. Where I come from, after I received the warmth and lively vigor from a number of champions, I lay with the remains of an exalted noble to grant him another chance at life. To do so is the purpose of my being. But before I could bear the noble into new life, I was awakened by the guidance of grace and chased from my birthplace. Pray, be kind. Despite all that, I still wish to be a deathbed companion. So please, let me hold you like this as often as it takes.
So I'm curious, and this might be some fucked up idea I came up with that I just think might be a thing, but also George R. R. Martin had some writing involvement in this game. So when a guy is undead, or just dead, does she, you know, do the coitus with them? And because she did the coitus, because she's a deathbed companion, do they come back to life from said coitus instead of, you know, her getting, you know, basically having a muffin baking in the oven? Because that is some fucked up, that is a measurable fucked up level that George R. R. Martin and Miyazaki, I think, collectively could come up with together. And suddenly I'm questioning my statue. I'm just gonna stop there. I'm pretty sure everything I just said is complete and utter bullshit. That's not how it works, but she's the way she said it made me think that just maybe that she, you know, there might be some OSHA concerns down below, if you catch my drift.
My dear, have you ever heard of Black Knife Prints? Dear Roger likes to talk of them when abed, and the ancient plot in which the first of the demigods was slain. The black knives wielded by the assassins who committed the act, along with the impressions they made, somehow hide the truth of the conspiracy. These grand affairs are hardly my forte, but dear Roger began to weep as he spoke.
But now my other thing is that, you know, all fuck, no pun intended, fuckery, and also now jokes, and everything else aside, but, like, I'm wondering if she does that because she wants to keep people alive with her, death companioning, for lack of a better term. And if I'm full of shit, by all means, correct me if I'm wrong, and hey, have a good laugh at my expense for even coming up with just this fucked up idea that that's how she does things, but, I know Fia is a tarnished, and I know she's not technically evil. Actually, more or less, there's only a couple of evil characters in this game, which, you know, is kind of rare for the Soulsborne series, because none of the characters in Dark Souls 1, to my knowledge, are evil. Dark Souls 2, I think the Queen was kind of evil, but I can't speak of the DLC because I haven't played any of the DLCs of Dark Souls 2. Dark Souls 3, the only evil character, actually characters, were Pontiff Sullivan and the God Devourer, I forget his fucking name. They were the only two that I could think of that were, you know, quote, evil, but even they were simply corrupted. They weren't born evil, or, well, nobody's born evil, but they weren't inherently evil. They just got corrupted in the pursuit of power, so that's why they were evil. So it was their actions that made them evil, not necessarily, like, them as a person. And Bloodborne, I want to say, what's his ass that wears the cage on his head and you have to chase him? I can't remember his name to save my life, but I want to say that he was evil. But I don't know, Bloodborne's such a fucked up world that, like, honestly, the lines between good and evil are so fucking blurred. Like, they're really blurred as to who's evil, who's not. Because, like, Lawrence is kind of the reason why everything went to shit. But even he had, you know, the best of intentions. Like, he wasn't a bad dude. He just, you know, wanted to heal people. But he didn't, you know, heed, what's that dude's name? Master, his master's, advice in that, you know, fear the old blood, and, you know, he didn't fear the old blood enough because he overestimated his ability to, I guess, utilize it to heal people, and that started turning people into fucking weredogs and shit. Or weredogs. Werewolves. And then Sekiro, I'm not familiar with the lore of Sekiro, so I can't really speak to that one. With Elden Ring, though, I don't know, I mean, I guess it's kind of like the FromSoft, like, approach to things, is that the world's so fucked up that it's like the lines of good and evil are just too blurred to really comprehend as to who's really the bad guy or who's the good guy. Because at the end of the day, everybody seeks an end to the chaos going on right now. That's what I'm interpreting, at least so far. And again, with a lot of the lore of this game, that's where I'm going in blind, because a lot of this lore I didn't pay attention to. I didn't really focus on it. The only thing I know is pretty much the main plot, but a lot of the companion side quests and the, the NPC side quests, not companion side quests. What the hell am I talking about? That's the shit that's mostly familiar with me. Like, I'm familiar with Fia's quest line because I've completed it. I have fought the end quest line boss that's involved with this one. I've done some of the other bigger ones that give you different ending choices. Like, those I've done. But there's some other ones that I haven't really touched on all that much. Like, for example, Selen's questline. I haven't really fucked with that one all that much. And I'm hoping to engage in it a bit more. And I just realized I've gone on for almost 2 hours. So I'm gonna wrap this video up, get it processed, so that way I can watch it, make sure that this new headset works, which, based on what OBS has been showing me, because, yeah, if you see my head, like, tilt over this way, I'm looking at you guys and gals, and I'm also looking at the meters and whatnot, but I also want to make sure that my volume is good enough for the game, because I know my microphone volume is, like, good to go, but the game audio might be a little quiet, but we'll see. Anyways.
In truth, I've heard tell from someone else about the black knife prints that fascinate dear Roger so...
Oh, that's for Liurnia, I believe that's what it's called.
It wouldn't be right to give this to him, stuck as he is in the round table hold. Perhaps you could make use of it?
Suddenly it's cold in here. I like how your character, like, takes out their sword and shit, like, alright, time to die, bitch. let me see if... What's her pants is about? Oh, she's down here. I can't open that door yet. Okay, that's the door we'll open up later on. All right, she should be near, yeah, she should be over here, down this way, near the fucking Twin Maidens or whatever. Oh, hey, Gideon's thing is open. What's up, dude? Oh, she's not here yet. Okay. Oh, wait, do I have any bells to offer? I don't have any bells to offer. I don't really have anything to buy either. Okay. I figured she'd be by that table, actually. That table right there. Excuse me. Right there. Broke that book set again. Okay, let me rest there and see if that changes anything. Okay, yeah, because Gideon moved over here, so... Ah, there she is. Cool.
You again.
Me again.
I thought you'd receive a summons to the round table. Nefeli Lu, we met at Stormvale.
Indeed.
I'm glad to see you here. I have something for you. I found it in Godric's grafting grounds. You defeated him. You should have it. Make good use of it. I don't intend to make a habit of scavenging corpses.
Oh, that lowers the equipment load.
Ah, yes. I wonder if you've met my foster father. He's in his study. The room Ensure's guarding just over there. If you haven't already, I advise you introduce yourself. Father is leader of the Round Table. I'm sure talking to him will be worth your while. It's about time I headed off. I'll see you again, warrior, should the fates deign it.
Is that all?
It's about time. I'll see you again.
Yeah, okay, right. Cool. All right, so she's there, and then he's in his study now. And yeah, he's basically head of this area that we're in. Actually, yeah, we could go talk to him and get some more tidbits.
You've received the wisdom of the Two Fingers, have you not? Then I bid you welcome as a true member of the Round Table. I am known as Gideon Ofnir. As a tarnished who wishes to stand before the Elden Ring and become Elden Lord, I am accumulating knowledge to be all-knowing. You now belong to a select group of fellows. As such, I ask that you remain constant.
Yes, boss.
You'll be after more great runes now, eh? Then as your fellow, allow me to divulge a little knowledge. The inheritors of the Great Runes, the Shard Bearers. We of the Round Table know the location of five of them, including... including the one you defeated. Godric the Grafted, Lord of Stormvale. General Radahn, who fought Melania and her rot to a standstill in the Caelid Wilds. Praetor Rykard, Lord of the Volcano Manor of Mount Gelmir. Morgoth the Grace-Given, Veiled Monarch and Lord of Laendel. And Rennala, Queen of the Full Moon, ruler of Rhea Lucaria's Academy. You'll still be after more great runes, won't you?
I love his fucking Scottish accent. Like, just... It just so rolls so well off of his tongue. Like, this guy's VA is just, you know, chef's kiss to that.
So, Godric the Grafted, Lord of Stormvale. Despite being the blood of Godfrey, First Elden Lord, he's a grotesque old fool grasping for power. His castle lies upon the cliff to Limgrave's northwest, but I suspect you know that well enough already.
Considering I killed him, yeah.
General Radahn, the famed Red Lion and Scourge of the Stars, is a ferocious warrior. He fought Melania and her rot to a standstill in the Caelid Wilds to Limgrave's east. And now Caelid has been engulfed by the Scarlet Rot. Even approaching the region is no mean feat. I've heard survivors of Radahn's army are still in the wilds, staving off the rot with fire. And if it's true, I suspect Radahn is still there as well, in Caelid. Though, I doubt he much resembles his former self anymore.
And then, yeah, of course, as I'm sure most of you know, Caelid's that region we explored that's like a desert with, like, weird mutant dogs and birds and dead people and all kinds of weird shit. But yeah, Radahn is... Let me see. Well, Margoth's not necessarily a bad dude. Rennala's not necessarily a bad one. And Nefeli, that's the chick out there. She's not one of the demigods. But yeah, I would say out of the bunch... Actually, even Godric wasn't necessarily a bad dude. He was just batshit insane. Like, I think he had inferiority complex where he thought that he was equal to, like, Radahn, Rykard, Margoth, and everybody else, even though he wasn't, because he's a distant relative to Godwin. And so he thought himself as equal to them, but in reality, he wasn't. He was inferior to them. But, that kind of makes him a little bit of a tragic figure when he's, you know, the lesser of his family. The Lance Lannister of the Lannisters, if you will.
Morgoth the Grace-Given is Lord of Laendel, the capital city. It lies at the foot of the Erd Tree, in the east of the Altus Plateau. But the Two Fingers forbid us from venturing there. Until we've acquired enough great runes to repair the Elden Ring. Set your sights elsewhere for the time being. The Veiled Monarch can wait.
Actually, I believe he's the... Yeah, Morgoth, I believe, is the king of Lindell. Like, he's the head honcho of Lindell amongst, you know, the various demigods here. Or he's the, quote, the current... legitimate king, even though Rennala is, you know, like, I guess I would make her a queen, dowager, since her husband's kind of, presumed dead, but, anyhoot.
The Academy of Rhea Lucaria lies to Limgrave's north, towering over the mist-laden lands of Liurnia. Rennala is queen of the Carian royals, who govern the Academy, but Rennala herself is no demigod.
Her beloved Radagon
left her to become Queen Marika's second husband, taking the title of King Consort. The Great Rune dwells within the Amber Egg that was Radagon's gift to her.
Okay, so yeah, Rennala isn't a demigod, but, let's see, Radahn, Radahn, Rickard... And there's another one we're going to meet called Ronnie, are the children of Godwin, or not Godwin, Godfrey. And that's, I think, what I meant to refer to when I was talking about Godric is, yeah, Godfrey and Marika are the parents of Radahn, Rickard, and Ronnie. Radagon is the father of Melania, and then they have their, she has a brother. And then prior to them, the demigods were Godric, Marika, and Godwin. Was Godwin the son of Godfrey and Marika? There was Godwin. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. The first line of children was Morgott, Godwin, and then there's another one. And then there was another line that was Radahn, Ronny, and Rykard. And then below them is Melania and her twin brother. That's how the whole lineage works. Okay. And then about Nefeli.
I understand you've been speaking to Nefeli. She's my daughter. I took her in when she lost the guidance of grace. Though a mere axe-wielding barbarian, her youthful credulity suited my purposes. So I put her to work. Do not hesitate to employ her. Should her services benefit you? Despite her looks, she is more than capable in the press of battle.
Oh, we know that already. She fought alongside us against Godric. Okay, so yeah, like I said, this tidbit's gonna be a little bit lore heavy. I know I've gone on for 2 hours, and yeah, I want to do basically catch up with all the lore that I failed to read, but I'm gonna focus more on can I actually view weapons and inventory or no? Okay, I can't. Cool. I'm going to focus more upon, like, storyline, like, things I know are attached to the storyline, as opposed to, let me go ahead and use that, get that out of the way, as opposed to just reading every single tidbit, because there's other Let's Players that do that, obviously, I'm going to read this, of course, the remembrance of Godric the Grafted, hewn into the Erd Tree. The power of it seems it can be unlocked. Da 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 da. A feeble man sought power through the grotesque act of grafting. One day we'll return together to our home, bathed in rays of gold. So, yeah, that's basically our first storyline boss defeated. Oh, whoops, wrong button. Yeah, I don't care about the PvP stuff, so that's that one dealt with. Oh, perfect. I don't even have to hit the button. It just rolled through. The spirits of nobles who, after death, now wander the lands between. Surely they were in search of something once, but whatever it was has long been forgotten. And we've seen them wandering around, collecting runes and berries and shit. And it's just like, what are they looking for? Now, my original thought with them is that they were working for Godric, and they were looking for fragments of the Elden Ring. I think that's what I kind of interpreted initially with them, but I think now they're just like nobles that have died so many times they don't even know what the hell they're looking for anymore. Or that the ruins are either remnants of their old estates, or they remind them of their old estates, and that's why they pick up bits of the rubble and whatnot. Spirit of a nobleman who once asked to be given a place at Raya Lucaria to learn Glintstone sorceries. His talents were insufficient to be worthy of donning the stone crown, however, and he is only capable of using the most rudimentary sorcery. So yeah, he's pretty much not a very capable sorcerer. He can only use like the basic abilities of them. These are the spirits of militiamen who live in death and will continue to rise again until properly finished off. This is the grotesque fate of those who come into contact with Deathroot, which Deathroot's been that stuff we've been collecting for Garonk, who Mr. D directed us to and said, hey, like, I used to be this guy's champion to collect this stuff, but I'm busy with other stuff. Do you want to take over? You are? Okay, cool. Well, here's how you meet him, and then he'll tell you, like, hey, these items you need to find out where the Deathroot is. Spirits of demi-humans that are small in stature but have a violent, brutish disposition. Though they seem somewhat intelligent, when night falls, their blood boils and they become feral. Yeah, I want to say that... actually, that makes a lot of sense now that I think about it. At night, demi-humans are a lot more aggressive than they are during the day. But yeah, I think I mentioned this also before, is that demi-humans are not evil. They're not bad people. They're actually benevolent creatures, I want to say, as opposed to the Misbegotten, which are malevolent. Like, the Misbegotten are disgusting evil creatures, which we fought Leonine, we fought them in other places, like at the Fort Haight, and then Castle Morn, we fought them there. Yeah, they're fucking evil, violent creatures. But the demi-humans are actually not that evil. Spirits of wolves chase from their pack. They later encountered a nameless Tarnished who welcomed them as hunting companions. The wolf spirits overwhelm enemies with their agility, aiding the summoner in combat. Yeah, the wolves served us well against Leonine. Actually, it would have been fitting if I had the demi-humans with me to fight Leonine, but anyways. A floating spirit that illuminates its surroundings. Prone to tears? The jellyfish girl searches for her distant home. Will bravely spew poison at foes on her summoner's behalf. It seems her name is Aurelia. So, there's two things I know about this jellyfish in particular, is that her sister is actually out and about moving around. I want to say in Liurnia. The other one I've heard is that the jellyfish are actually the spirits of dead children. So, Aurelia and her sister were basically kids that were killed, and, you know, Aurelia became, you know, a spirit, and then her sister became just, you know, another jellyfish floating about. I don't recall where I heard that, though, so that could be 100% wrong. But yeah, the jellyfish summon just chef's kiss to her. Actually, you can have them meet together. I might actually do that. I'll have to do my little, you know, due diligent research, but I might actually explore that if I remember to. Excuse me, son of a bitch, if I remember to do it. Banish that Oleg, which Oleg's a champ, like, he's a fucking Chad. One of the two knights noticed the wings of the storm. After his banishment, he attracted the notice of the grace-given lord, and later, having slain 100 traitors as the lord's hand, Oleg earned the hero's honor of Erdtree Barrow. Now, I believe I got him from that Erdtree spirit that I killed, the one that I said that I've never done that well against him, or it, at the low level that I was at. One of two knights dubbed the Wings of the Storm. Oh, yeah, so we got the two brothers here. Well, you know, brothers in arms, not like literal brothers. Despite his banishment, he rejected... Wait, hold on. I have the same thing. Oh, instead of keeping watch over a master's castle for many years, getting renowned as Hero of the Fringes. Oh, so they were both banished. He attracted the notice of the Grace-Given Lord. He rejected the invitation of the Grace-Given Lord. He slayed a bunch of traitors at the Lord's hand. He earned the hero's honor of Erdtree Burial. Instead, keeping watch over a masterless castle for many years, getting renowned as a hero of the fringes. Okay, so both of these sound like respectable dudes. Lutel the Headless. Spirit of a headless knight who leads the mausoleum soldiers, wields a lance enrobed in death, and hurls spectral lances at foes. Oh, her life, she's a chick. Oh, okay. Suddenly, you know, it's a little hot here. I always appreciate a badass woman. But Lutel, I believe that's how you say her name, sacrificed her life so that in death she could continue to protect a soulless demigod until their revival, earning her the hero's honor of Erdtree Burial. So I wonder if she was kind of looking over Godwin to protect a soulless demigod until the revival. Yeah, I wonder if she's kind of like, not necessarily in league with Fia, but if she's like at least affiliated with Godwin, like she's waiting for Godwin to come back to life. And I like how her head garment's like floating above where her head used to be. I like that. I don't think we got to read any of these necessarily. Oh yeah, I gotta cash in that sacred tear. Don't necessarily need to read over any of these. Have you collected any paintings? Oh, I can give that. Can be given to a learned sorcerer to gain the following sorceries: Glintblade Phalanx and Carrion Slicer. I think I might be able to give that to that one guy we met outside of Stormvale. I suppose we can look at the... Yeah, let's look at this one. The Storied Sword of Castle Morn, Revenger's Weapon. Oh, that's... No, never mind. I've read this one already. And I'm playing catch-up with my old ones. So yeah, I don't have enough. The large spikes make it highly effective in inducing blood loss. Hard actually to wield. Yeah, I'm looking for things to have like lore attached to them. That way I can, you know, talk about it, but. Incantations must be. I mean, what the thing looks like is, like for your pets that have, like, you know, nails and whatnot, like cats, dogs, ferrets, whatever. Like, it looks like something that you would, you know, do this, or, hold on. You would do this number, like, you would, Oh, damn, I don't have my can opener. Fuck. I guess these will work. Oops. I guess these will work, but, like, okay, for example, like, with this pair of scissors I got here, like, let's say those are the two knobs. You do that number and it like clips the nail. Like that's what I was kind of interpreting from that thing, but I guess that's clearly not how it works. But actually, with the circular thing, it looks like it would clip off somebody's finger. Sneered at by fools in the academy. The demi, yeah, the demi-humans are kind of like looked down upon by everybody. Those are all of our arrows. Some say it is the curse of grafting which causes such affliction, while others talk of its root being something altogether more sinister, hidden deep within the castle. Yeah, I mean, I was when I had that earlier when I, you know, I saw that it doesn't have a skill attached to it. I was like, yeah, what is that thing? Because it was reminding me of another boss I encountered like way later on in the game, and I'm like, no, it doesn't look anything like that technically. It just has a similar like, you know, aesthetic to it, but it's like, oh, it's just a root. Like, there's a root growing on this leather shield. Features a beast's crest serving to remind warriors not to succumb to the arousal of battle. Fight with passion, but become not its prisoner. What's our heat shield say? Metal shields reliably negate physical damage when. Okay, they don't even tell us anything. Depicts a round, the round table. Oh, wait, hold on. Did I read the wrong thing about it then? Meme shield. Meme shield comparatively easy to handle. Okay. Yeah, favored by bandits, which, you know, fits my Jinx character. Which, yeah, I would think. Now that I'm thinking about it, it would make more sense for me to go for sorceries. Or actually, no, it would make more sense for me not to go for either incantations or sorceries, but to go for tricks and traps with my Jinx character. Yeah, I don't have anything really here. About the Cave of Knowledge. Do I have any. Oops, wrong button. Do I have any of the paintings? Oh, okay, I've got this one. And that I know is like in the upper right area of Liurnia, next to the Erdtree there. Minor Erdtree. Stranger sort of captured the landscape scene during the last moments of those who welcomed death's embrace. The soul of the painter, da da da. Can be discovered by visiting the location depicted there. I don't remember that location. Wait, hold on. Is that a guy riding a horse? No, those are two guys riding horses. I mean, I know that's. I don't know where the hell that is. That's also why I'm not going to bother with the paintings, because it's just one of the things I just don't feel I the need to be bothered with, because I didn't bother with them in my first, second, or third playthrough, and I'm not being bothered with them in this one. So, that reminds me. Oh yeah, okay. So yeah, I've already been able to have two. Yeah. So all right, I can get a sacred tear, and I can increase that. So let me go ahead and do that number right now. Yeah, increase amount. Yep. I don't think I can add a char. Yeah, I need three, so I need a third one. Because I only think I only have two. Pretty sure I only have two. Yeah, okay. There we go. We only got two. All right. But still, 8 and 6 is a really great start to where I'm at in the game. No, I don't necessarily need to like cash in and get that item from what's her face. So yeah, I think yeah, 2 hours and 20 minutes. Holy shit. We got a lot done this video. Oh. But yeah, I have been Devil Jinx, because I know I changed my name as of the recording of this video. But I've been Devil Jinx. This has been Let's Play Elden Ring, and I will see you all next time where we continue on my journey, or my fifth journey now through Elden Ring, or fourth journey, excuse me. See you all then. Bye!